people, like population density in Hong Kong in that particular area, 43,000 per square kilometer, whereas you have in Gurgaon is 1,241. What this tells you, at the same time you have Gurgaon, which is, you know, we have talked about the issues, whereas Hong Kong, if you go to Kowloon, even TST, I don't know how many of you visited Hong Kong, but if you walk in TST, there's a lot of people walking in, especially the older parts of TST. Again, I'm not giving you the impression that Hong Kong is perfect. To me, I think no city is perfect. It cannot be perfect. It's something that evolves. So you can try and get it as best as possible for it to work well. And one thing I can do say for Hong Kong, it works well in terms of it runs efficiently. So you don't have the gridlocks or like, you know, what Beijing and other places suffered from. And this is the grid pattern in the different cities. Hong Kong on the other side, Shanghai, and you see Gurgaon actually on this scale looks better than the others. Skyline, you can see different cities. I think skylines are important, as well as what happens on the ground is equally important. And if you look at just focusing now on Hong Kong, it's a compact city, mainly because out of its 1,000 square kilometers, only 25% of the land is actually accommodating the 7 million population. About more than 40% is country park, and the population density is over 6,000 per square kilometer. So certain areas it could go as high as 65,000 people per square kilometer, but that's another story. So in terms of transit, number of vehicles is around 707,000 in 2011, car ownership about 59 per thousand. Vehicle road per kilometer is about 251 in 2008. So public transport, I think the biggest gain for Hong Kong is about over 90% of the passenger people can actually access public transport. I think the question is, it's not so much the car ownership and everything, it's like how much you really need to use it. Like if you take some cities in the US, if you don't have a car, you can almost forget. You almost cannot live. I think that's wrong for a city. You need to have a city that has choice, where you can choose what kind of transit you want to take, and you can take. And it makes sense for you to take more transit rather than drive your own car. I think that would be great. Not saying that cars are